Tesh Dile, and welcome to Tibet This Week. This is Sakina Butt with another edition of Weekly News on Tibet, His Holiness the Dalai Lama, and Central Tibetan Administration. Let's look at the headlines first. His Holiness the Dalai Lama speaks at the 52nd National Convention of the All India Association of Catholic Schools. His Holiness the Dalai Lama begins three-day teachings for Asian Buddhists in Dharamshala. Tibetans in Dharamshala commemorate the 59th anniversary of Tibetan Democracy Day. Health Kalon attends the 18th North America Tibetan Association's conference. Europe Tibetan Association's first annual general meeting begins. Highlighting human rights situation in Tibet, CTA delegation advocates at the UN. The Dalai Lama scientist premiered at the 76th Venice International Film Festival. His Holiness the Dalai Lama met with a group of about 250 young Tibetans during his visit to Mangaluru in Karnataka on Friday last week. Addressing the students, His Holiness recalled hearing about claims that Tibet had long been part of China made in an exhibition in Beijing in the 70s. His Holiness spoke about Songten Gompo's marriage to a Chinese princess and Genghis Khan's giving Dragon Chogyal Pakpa control over Tibet. His Holiness further told them to remember that Tibet is the land of Avalokiteshvara, the patron deity of the land of snows. China has tried to eliminate Tibetan tradition and failed. The Chinese depend on the power of the gun, but Tibetans depend on the power of truth, His Holiness said. During his visit, the Tibetan spiritual leader also addressed a 1,000-strong audience that included 150 students from the Himalayan region as well as Catholic educationalists during the 52nd National Convention of the All India Association of Catholic Schools. Addressing the huge audience, His Holiness spoke about compassion and claimed that all 7 billion human beings are one community. His Holiness said the education system that focused on material values gives rise to the negligence on the basic human qualities of kindness and compassion.
Some scientists say our basic nature is more compassionate. It is quite understandable. We are social animals. Therefore, any social animal, individual's survival or individual's happiness entirely depend on the community. So therefore, as a social animal, from birth, our basic nature is more compassionate.
His Holiness urged that education shouldn't only be about cultivating our brains, but need warm-heartedness too. His Holiness the Dalai Lama returned to Dharamshala on Sunday this week and started his three-day teachings for the Asian Buddhist on Wednesday this week. Attended by more than 5,000 devotees from 67 countries, the first day of the teaching was on the Four Noble Truths and their 16 characteristics and the 37 factors of enlightenment, as well as Nagarjuna's commentary on Bodhicitta. Tibetans in Dharamshala commemorated the 59th anniversary of the Tibetan Democracy Day in Suglakang on Monday this week. The chief guest of the event, Srimati Sarveen Chaudhary, Honorable Minister of Urban Development, Town and Country Planning, Government of Himachal Pradesh, in her keynote address, applauded the exiled Tibetans for their non-violent approach to the freedom struggle, which has garnered strong international community support to their cause.
One of the first pronouncements made by His Holiness after arriving in India was to ensure a democratic system of governance would be born in exile. And on his very day in 1960, the first meeting of the Tibetan Parliament in exile was held with members representing each of the three traditional provinces and the four major schools of Tibetan Buddhism in 1963.
On behalf of Kasha and the Tibetan people, Venerable Karma Gelik Yuthok explained the evolution of the Tibetan democracy and the immeasurable gift of His Holiness the Dalai Lama to the Tibetan people.
Today, after 59 years, we Tibetan people in exile are enjoying a vibrant and progressive democracy. It's primarily, if not solely, because of the great leadership of His Holiness the great 14th Dalai Lama and the great kindness and generosity of the people and government of India.
The event also saw presentation of awards and cultural performances by the school children and the artists of Tibetan Institute of Performing Arts. Tibetan national flag was raised for the second consecutive year in the London Borough of Waltham Forest Council, marking the 59th anniversary of the Tibetan Democracy Day at the northwest of London. The 18th North America Tibetan Association's conference was inaugurated at Funso Deshe Hall, North California, on Saturday last week. The three-day conference was attended by 40 representatives from 24 different regional Tibetan associations. The chief guest, Kalon Chokyong Wangchuk of Department of Health, informed about the critical situation inside Tibet and urged Tibetan children abroad to put efforts in learning Tibetan language and particularly requested the parents to speak Tibetan with their children. He further explained the 550 vision of Central Tibetan Administration and the Tibetan Medicare system under the Department of Health. The conference discussed five major topics, including the offering of long life prayers for His Holiness the Dalai Lama, strengthening Tibet advocacy and preservation of Tibetan language, culture and Buddhism. For the first time, a two-day general meeting of Europe Tibetan Associations was held at Casa del Tibet, Barcelona, Spain on Saturday last week. 20 representatives comprising of presidents, vice presidents, and executive members from 12 Tibetan associations and communities participated in the annual meeting. The agenda of the two-day meeting include promotion and preservation of Tibetan language, Tibet awareness and political activities in Europe, strengthening existing Tibetan community, key themes of the upcoming third special general meeting to be held in Dharamshala, which are 550 vision and lineage of His Holiness the Dalai Lama's and Tibetan people. The meeting was convened by Tibet Bureau in Geneva and members of Tibetan Parliament in exile from Europe in close coordination with offices of Tibet in London, Brussels and Paris's coordinator. A delegation from the Central Tibetan Administration has embarked on a week-long advocacy for Tibet at the United Nations in Geneva to highlight the current human rights situation in Tibet. This advocacy at the UN comes ahead of the UN Human Rights Council's 42nd regular session that will begin from 9 September 2019 in Geneva. During the meetings with several UN permanent missions to the UN based in Geneva and UN human rights officials, the delegations apprised them on the situation of human rights that continue to deteriorate. The team urged the UN's attention and intervention in specific cases, such as the resumption of large-scale demolition and eviction at Yachinkar this year. In addition to briefing on the issues in Tibet, the team also presented 10 recommendations to China. Nearly half of Yachinkar Buddhist complex situated in Tibet's Kharzai region, which is now incorporated into China's Sichuan province, has been demolished by Chinese authorities. In an effort to cover the demolition, the Chinese authorities have covered the ground with green plastic. Thousands of monks and nuns were forcefully evicted and are being subjected to the so-called patriotic re-education camp and are not even allowed to wear their Buddhist robes. Here is what Mr. Arya, Secretary of Department of Information, said about the situation in Tibet.
Yeah, situation in Tibet these days has gone from bad to worse, and today the Tibet is virtually close to the outside world. And through its powerful military presence in Tibet, the China has occupied Tibet physically, but then these days now they are trying to occupy the Tibetan spiritual realms, and they're trying to destroy the Tibetan language and the Tibetan spiritualisms, and by taking control over the religious activities of the Tibetan people. And this is a gross violation of religious and the cultural human rights of the people there. And recently, there is a great destruction since from the 2017, the Larungar and Yashingar monasteries, Thousands of monks and nuns have been evicted from the place. And now the Yachengar, we were reported that almost half of the area has been destroyed and dismantled. And it has been replaced by the plastic grass. So this is a very bad, and this is against the, not only to the Tibetan people, but there are many Chinese practitioners also. It is a great loss to the old heritage, the Nalanda traditions. And we urge the Chinese authorities that they should sincerely respect the Tibetan sentiments, their religious and the culturals, so that Tibetan could also respect the Chinese authority, and we can come and come out with a good solution on the Tibetan issues.
The much-awaited film, The Dalai Lama Scientist, was premiered at the 76th Venice International Film Festival within the Venice Production Bridge on Saturday last week. The 1 hour and 35 minutes long documentary film features the full history of His Holiness the Dalai Lama's fascination with science and his persistent efforts at bringing the scientific community and Buddhist scholars in the conversation from the 70s to the recent period. The documentary is a Peace Jam Productions, written and directed by Don Engel and produced by Ivan Suvanjeev, and is a part of Nobel Laureate's legacy series of Peace Jam Foundation, established in 1996. So much for this week's edition of Tibet This Week. See you next time and have a great weekend.